sa totoo lang, nung sabihin sa amin ni Architect Minister Edward Guerra, natatapusin niya itong facilities na ito in the period of 45 days, medyo may personal po akong alinlangan doon. A facility as big as this, matatapos siya within 45 days. But, for the record, tinapos niya ito within 40 days. And we have to give him the applause and recognition that really he deserved. Pero ang sabi ko ngayon kay Minister Ed, baka pwede na yung mga ipapatayo namin ng mga BHS, mga rural health unit, mga health facilities, diretso na lang natin imuha sa kanila. Kasi kung ganito na natatapos kagad, wow! I can only see the extent of the performance of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region to serve our people.
Chief Minister has tasked the Public Works to implement plan and execute the construction of these facilities. So I accepted. After a while, medyo apprehensive ako. May lockdown. Walang hardware, walang movement ng mga tao, yung workers, how to mobilize. Pero, alhamdulillah, nakaya natin because I promise the Chief Minister within 1 month. And exactly 41 days yesterday, natapos natin yung project natin. And right time and quality, yan importante, with quality. Hindi lang basta natapos, but with quality. Kaya lang naman, hands-on tayo pag-supervise it. So, alhamdulillah. And you see, this structure, normally when you say isolation, temporary, di ba? But we made it permanent. Anyway, gagastusin naman tayo. Itong idea ni Chief Minister, gagastus tayo. Bakit natin hindi paggawing permanent? At this time, magagamit ng hospital, ng sanitarium, as their expansion. Andiyan na eh.
During this time of the COVID-19 onslaught, the whole nation and the world was tested to its maximum limits and has suffered its devastating effect. We have seen what this virus can do to our health and body. We have seen what is its effect on our economy, and most especially, we have seen its effect on what it can do to our daily lives. But what COVID-19 did not see is the response, is our response as a people. In times of crisis, the Bangsamoro stood tall. The Bangsamoro responded beyond what is expected of him. But most importantly, the Bangsamoro has not surrendered and lost to the unseen enemy. Like the highly regarded Mujahideens, the Bangsamoro fought back and made the necessary actions. And now, we are seeing the fruition of this response. No one has ever given thought that this will be a reality in 40 days' time, especially when they knew that it will be built by the Bangsamoro. But yes, we have proven them wrong. The Bangsamoro can do it, and that is what you call moral governance at its best.
Pero alam po natin, hindi ito magiging posible. If not because of the all-out support of our beloved Chief Minister, at nagpapasalamat po tayo sa kanya dahil yung mga programa nating pangkalusugan tulad ng ganito at saka yung mga iba pa ay talagang sinusuportahan niya ng todo-todo, whether moral support, monetary support, lahat po binibigay niya sa amin. Kaya kung mayroon man tayong mga humble achievements ngayon is because of the support of our own Chief Minister at lahat ng kanyang kasamahan sa office of the Chief Minister.
First step, we finished the projects. We now officially turn over this project to the Chief Minister. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
nakita natin na unang-una, yung tungkol sa medical services na prioritize natin. Kung hindi natin yung na-prioritize, siguro mahirapan tayong mag-gawa ng ganito mga kung kasi kung minsan ko lang pan kailangan para walang contingency fund, ang mangyayari maglabi pa tayo sa kwan sa parliament na gawin ito. So alam niyo na yung action natin sa COVID-19, the national government itself nag-declare na tayo ang unang-unang region na na talagang nagkaroon ng very effective na action against COVID-19. That is the beauty of a government na may autonomous power. Kasi wala na silang problema, automatic na they can appropriate their budget. Aside dito, unang-unang ginawa natin yung pag-upgrade sa capacity ng CRMC dahil the whole of the Barm area, wala tayong hospital na may capacity for testing. So, in-upgrade natin yung kwan. Nagbigay tayo ng 14 million na para ma-upgrade ang capacity ng CRMC. Ngayon, CRMC is already capable of testing COVID-19. Itong mga facilities na ganito, we can easily budget kasi sabi ko nga, nandyan, mayroon tayong contingency. Actually now, we have already spent more than 2 billion para sa programa natin for addressing the COVID-19 situation. After na mga ngayon, and then yung pag-upgrade natin sa CRMC, lahat ng mga provincial hospital nagre-request ngayon na kwan. Sabi ko, sige, tingnan natin. We will try our best na matulungan kayo para ma-upgrade natin. Kasi para din naman yun sa inyo lahat. The VIATF made sure that basic services were delivered. Preventive measures were in place. And most importantly, sustainable efforts were made to assure that we can isolate and manage COVID-19. As a result of our resolve to combat this disease, here we are today fulfilling another phase in this battle. In the name of moral governance agenda that we are pushing during the transition period, and despite the challenges brought upon by quarantine measures as well as the solemn observance of the holy month of Ramadan, our colleagues from the Ministry of Public Works were able to construct this 100-bed isolation building for COVID-19 patients within 41 days. This is just one of the various isolation buildings either constructed or converted by our dear friends from the MP, Ministry of Public Works, and other local government units to prepare when worst comes to worst. Although we are doing everything we can to avoid such a scenario, it is indeed better to be prepared than to be caught off guard. Thank you so much to Minister Guerra and congratulations for his team for making this happen. And of course, we are confident that the Cotabato Sanitarium Hospital will take good care of this facility and we remain committed in strengthening the status of healthcare in the region. Let us continue praying that the right amount of cooperation and dedication from all sectors, including the public, we can and we will beat COVID-19, inshallah. Thank you very much. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.